Welcome to Understand the Math. Today I'm going to teach you the easy way to square a binomial. I'll walk through the three example problems listed here and show you exactly what to do. Be sure to check out the link below for free guided notes that you can use while you watch this video. There's space in the notes for you to highlight the concepts that we'll go over and fill out the answers to the examples that we're going to do. When you square a binomial, there's two ways to do it. You can use the FOIL method, or you can use the binomial square formula, which is what I would call the easy way. In our first example, we're going to square the binomial using the FOIL method and using the binomial square formula, so you can see why the binomial square formula works. Let's do the FOIL method first. We have 5x plus 3 quantity squared, which is equal to 5x plus 3 times 5x plus 3. F stands for first, and we multiply the first terms and get 25x squared. O stands for outer, and we multiply the outer terms, and that gives us 15x. I stands for inner, and we multiply the inner terms, and this gives us another 15x. And then L stands for last, and we multiply our last terms, and we get 9. We'll now combine like terms and write our final answer. This gives us 25x squared plus 30x plus 9. Let's now look at the three terms that we have in our answer. The first term is 25x squared, and that is just 5x times 5x. The second term is 5x times 3 doubled, which is 30x. And our last term is 3 squared. This leads us to the binomial square formula. A plus or minus b quantity squared is equal to a squared plus or minus 2ab plus b squared. This is equal to our first term squared plus or minus 2 times our first term and last term plus our last term squared. Let's now walk through our second example, squaring it the easy way by using the binomial square formula. 2x minus 5 quantity squared is equal to our first term, which is 2x squared. We have a minus sign here, so our next term is going to be minus. So we have minus 2 times our first term, 2x, times our last term, which is 5. Plus our last term squared. This gives us 4x squared minus 2 times 2 times 5, which is a 20, so minus 20x plus 25. Let's now look at our third example. I wanted to make sure and include this example because it contains terms that are a little bit more complicated, and you might come across a problem like this. We have 3x squared minus 4y quantity squared. This is equal to our first term, 3x squared squared, minus, notice that the signs match up, 2 times our first term, 3x squared, times our last term, 4y, plus our last term squared. This gives us a final answer of 9x to the fourth, and then we have 2 times 3 times 4, which is 24, so we have a minus 24x squared y plus 16y squared. When you do enough of these problems, you'll be able to bypass this first step and jump right to the final answer. If this video has been helpful to you, please consider subscribing to my channel. Keep believing in yourself and have a great rest of your day.